Salmon spawning is in full swing at Lake Sakakawea. I'm Mike Anderson with the North Dakota Game and Fish Department. My guest this week is fisheries biologist Russ Kinsler. Russ, a little different than last year.
It's a lot different than last year. Last year, most of the fish were caught below Garrison Dam in the tail race and then came up this hatchery stream. This year, it's more of a normal year and the fish are in Lake Sakakawea, and that's where we're catching them.
Okay, what was the reason last year? Why were they in the river versus the lake?
Last year, they were evacuating excess water in the lake, and they had the spillway gates open for the first time in the fall. And that's one of the spots that salmon like to congregate to try and spawn, and they just got pulled out of the lake and ended up in the river. So, you know, the vast majority of the fish we caught were in the river.
Russ, explain the process of salmon spawning.
So the first thing we do is we'll go out with the electrofishing boat in the backs of the bays and the bays closest to the dam in Lake Sakakawea, and we'll collect the fish. They're usually, the only fish we can collect are the ones that are up shallow, which are the ones that are mature and ready to spawn. So we'll collect the fish and we will haul them down to the hatchery at Garrison Dam. And then when we have enough fish gathered up, we'll take the milt out of the males and collect the eggs out of the females and mix them together and wall off fertilized eggs. At that point, and with the assistance of the hatchery, we'll do that. At that point, the hatchery will take them and put them in incubating jars where they'll stay for upwards of a month, a little over a month before they hatch. And then they hatch them into troughs and end up raising them into, you know, 5-inch salmon by May.
Okay, what is the goal for eggs this year?
This year, our goal is 1.4 million. It's similar to the last several years. With our hopes to stock 400,000 salmon in May of next year.
So you're collecting 1.4 million eggs, but we're releasing 400,000 fish into Lake Sakakawea next spring. Explain that.
Yeah, it's not a very good success ratio. And when you think about it, we're in North Dakota. Salmon are not native to North Dakota, so you can't expect that we're gonna have high success like they would in ocean, you know, fish that are coming into streams. So essentially, our long-term average is that we lose about 50% of the eggs from fertilization to when you can start seeing the eyes on the eggs. We call that eye up. So we lose about half the eggs to that point. And then from there till stocking, you know, we'll lose another percentage of fish. So that varies from year to year, how many, you know, what percentage is that. But yeah, that's basically from spawn to stock, we have about 30% survival.
Explain the partnership with the hatchery.
So we go out and collect the salmon from Lake Sakakawea. We bring them into the hatchery, and then we spawn the fish along with the hatchery staff. And then once the eggs are fertilized, then it's entirely on the hatchery to hatch the eggs, raise the fish, and then we will come in May next year and then haul the fish back into Lake Sakakawea.
Without this process, salmon wouldn't exist in Lake Sakakawea.
Yeah, for the most part, if we didn't spawn salmon in Lake Sakakawea, they would be virtually gone in 4 years. The vast majority of fish mature by age three, actually. The males mature at 1, 2, and 3 year olds. The females mature at age 2 and 3. So after 4 years, there might be one or two salmon out there, but they're virtually gone.
Okay. How are these fish looking?
They're looking really good this year. The females are about 2 pounds bigger than they were last year. The males are about a pound, pound and a half bigger, but they look good compared to last year and actually the last few years. Forage makes the fish bigger. We've had good numbers of rainbow smelt, which is the primary forage for salmon in Lake Sakakawea. We've had good numbers for several years. This year we've seen that it appears to be that the average size of those smelt has increased, and we're seeing that resulting in larger salmon. Salmon, when they spawn, try and return back to where they were born. So the salmon in Lake Sakakawea are, in a sense, trying to get back to Garrison Dam National Fish Hatchery. And the closest place they can do that is basically along the face of the dam or the bays closest to the face of the dam. So you will find them up in the shallowest water in those areas, and they're attempting to spawn. It's the closest they can get to where they were born. They don't successfully spawn because in the winter, Lake Sakakawea drops and those eggs will end up frozen in the ice and you know, won't hatch.
And at this time of year, you guys, this is a normal process through how long?
Yeah, generally they start moving shallow in the beginning of September, and by the end of September there are a fair number of fish shallow, and they'll start maturing and starting to trying to spawn right around the end of September, the beginning of October. And that's when we'll go out, usually the last few days of September, the first few days of October, and we'll start collecting fish. And we will collect fish basically the entire month of October to try and get representation from the entire spawn.
And every year you have certain challenges with weather, I'm guessing.
Yeah, every year, well, wind is a big thing because we're collecting fish super shallow. So if the wind is blowing in and trying to push us to shore, we can't collect them. So we have to pick and choose where we go each day to collect salmon. And, you know, nice calm days, we can go anywhere, and windy days, it makes it tough.
A lot of great information, Russ. Thank you.
For more information on the salmon program in North Dakota, visit the Game and Fish Department's website at gf.nd.gov.
For fisheries biologist Russ Kinsler and the rest of the staff here at the North Dakota Game and Fish Department, thanks for joining us this week. We'll see you again next week.